Thank you very much. Assalamu alaikum. It's an honor for me to be here. I appreciate the invitation that was extended.
And it's beautiful to see people from different backgrounds to stand up for what is right, to stand up for justice. We are here gathered today on the International Quds Day to speak up for the people of Palestine and to do all in our ability to stop this occupation. Unfortunately, we are standing here already 70 years of this occupation, 70 years of these brutal atrocities taking place. This continuous theft of land, murder and expulsion of the indigenous people of Palestine. We are here to express our pain for the conflicting wars which are continuing for so long. As we stand here, people in Gaza are standing on that so-called buffer zone, protesting in a peaceful resistance. And what happens to these people, as was described before? So many people have been killed and many more injured. And as a Jewish person, I am here to condemn this violation of Judaism going on for these 70 years. We have to remember that before the spread of Zionism in the 1920s in the Holy Land, Jews lived in peace with Muslims and with others, as was described here before. This is history that needs to be remembered. We need to use this past history in order to be able to vision the future. We lived in peace. Jewish people, the small minority amongst the vast majority of Muslims, we were respected and protected. By whom? By people from other religions. Why? Because the difference of religion was never a cause for conflict. We lived as loyal citizens amongst our neighbors, exactly how we are instructed and demanded by our religion. All what our Jewish communities in the Holy Land wanted was only the practice of their religion and their coexistence with their neighbors. Unfortunately, once this movement of Zionism came in with this agenda of power over others, at that point, sadly, this conflict began. This state of Israel was started in the Holy Land, not only against the will of the Palestinian Muslims. This was against the will of the Palestinian Jews at the time and of others. Jewish people, the leader of Judaism, of the Jewish community in the Holy Land, Rabbi Dushinsky, sent a testimony to the United Nations Special Committee in Jerusalem, saying that his community he represents, which was at the time 60,000 Jewish souls, reject to the idea of having a Jewish homeland in the Holy Land. To the present day, it's not only the Palestinians rejecting this occupation. It is the Jewish people in the Holy Land and worldwide who not only disagree, but publicly oppose all what Israel stands for. It's not only the Palestinians that refuse to recognize the legitimacy of the State of Israel who are oppressed by the Zionist regime. It is the Jewish people in the Holy Land who are brutalized because they protest and they disagree with this Zionist regime. People think that the State of Israel is about a safety and security of the Jewish people. This happens to be totally wrong. We don't need a State of Israel to protect the Jewish people. We have so many good-hearted people that we can live in peace with, and we did live in peace with. This State of Israel has only destroyed all of our peoples. Even today, we have masses of Jewish people worldwide who oppose the State of Israel. We have masses of Jewish people in the Holy Land when they dare to speak up in public to condemn this Zionist regime. What happens to those people? They are being brutalized, harassed, imprisoned, and all types of harassments.
Freedom for Palestine!
Justice for Palestine!
Freedom for Palestine!
Justice for Palestine!
Free, free Palestine!
Free, free Palestine!
Free, free Palestine!
Free, free Palestine!
It is our brave Jewish people in the Holy Land who stand strong against the Zionist regime. They refuse to serve in the Israeli army. And this is, you can imagine how difficult this is. The Israeli government in the recent years are doing all in their ability to force our youth to serve in the Israeli army, to physically carry out all these atrocities with their hands. And we would never do so. Our youth are being brutalized, arrested. Peoples who protest against these arrests are being brutalized, and this is going on already for years. Jews worldwide are embarrassed when all these atrocities, sadly, supposedly, is being committed in our name. It is a desecration of our religion when these people who don't follow anything within Judaism dare to misuse our religion to justify this very movement that is in an extreme contradiction to our religion. This is truly hypocrisy. Killing, stealing, occupying another's land, oppressing an entire people, all of this is totally forbidden within Judaism. This is not only a crime in international law. It's not only these crimes. It is actually the entire Jewish religion which is being violated by this heretical, officially secular movement, and again, still insists to call itself Jewish. The state of Israel is not Jewish at all, other than the inventors of this movement or people from Jewish descent who are embarrassed by the religion of their grandparents and turned their back to God and His religion. We have to remember and clarify that the state of Israel does not in any way represent the Jewish people. Jewish people worldwide not only oppose all what Israel is doing, but publicly come out in the streets and cry out their feelings against it. As we stand here, we have delegations of Jewish people in many major cities, in many countries throughout the world, to express their feelings and their opposition and on this special day, this International Quds Day. When we are dealing about this sad Jerusalem story, where we find the Zionist movement terrorizing, pressurizing government leaders to support their movement, to recognize their legitimacy, and to recognize Jerusalem as their capital. What we can say is that our people, our religion, our leaders from the very beginning of Zionism never accepted this movement as legitimate. Therefore, we cannot and will not accept Jerusalem as the capital of this illegitimate state. We plead with our President Trump of the United States of America to rethink this act. We are truly concerned about the Palestinian, the livelihood of the Palestinians, the disaster which was brought upon these people in the very beginning, and this continuation that sadly goes on to the present day. We are concerned about so many other people involved that might be affected from these moves. We express our solidarity with the Palestinian people. We condemn all atrocities being committed all these decades. We promote a totally free Palestine. We demand that all rights be returned to all Palestinians, including the full right of return. And we condemn this 7 decades and even more of violation against our religion. I encourage everyone to pray to Almighty God for this total dismantlement of this illegitimate state of Israel. We hope and we pray that this ends peaceful with no more suffering of anyone involved. So many people from so many different backgrounds have suffered. We don't want to see any suffering in the future. Ultimately, I pray for the glory of Almighty God be revealed throughout the universe, and we should merit to see the prayer that we say in our high holidays. All mankind should form one bond to serve you, God, in peace and harmony. Amen. Thank you very much. Assalamu alaikum.